that there are more or less we can say three main reasons for the independence.
Okay. Now? Yeah, there are three main reasons for the rise of independentism. The first one is that the people want more fiscal autonomy, okay? Especially when the economic crisis starts, a lot of people, there is a mantra that when you go to Catalonia, you always listen that it's like Madrid steals us, okay? The second one is that a lot of people doesn't understand, a lot of Catalan people doesn't understand why Catalonia cannot be recognized as a nation. We have all the ingredients to be recognized as a nation. Why we cannot be recognized as a nation? But it seems that the Spanish Constitution said that the only political subject and the only nation is Spain. So if they recognize Catalonia as a nation, this will mean to recognize Catalonia as a political subject. And finally, sorry, the third reason is that a lot of people in Catalonia get really angry with the Spanish government's lack of willingness to negotiate and to arrive to any agreement. They always say, no, we don't want to negotiate anything. So that's the reason why a lot of people, especially when the right-wing government of PP have been in power, they said, okay, I don't want more of this and I want the independence. And especially the first 2 points was what it was tried to be was tried to be introduced in the Catalan Statute. The Catalan Statute was a kind of Catalan constitution that after 25 years they tried to update it in 2006, and this was voted in a referendum where the 90% of the population said that they wanted this new statute, and then the Spanish Constitutional Court finally decided to partially suspend this Catalan constitution. So after that, I remember I was there almost 10 years ago. I felt like really bad treated by Spain, no? And then this generates a lot of protests, the first protest in the streets, and of course, then if you also add the economic crisis with all the austerity policies, the people want to find some kind of hope, no? And then independentism, of course, was a good way to say, hey, maybe if we become independent, we can solve all this and we can have a better future for all. But from these 2 points, it's true, for these 3 points, I think that it's true, it's objective, that the second and the third are quite true. But what about the first one? Is it really true that Madrid steals us? Is it true or not? So I remember that when I was teaching European integration at the University of Barcelona, I had the chance to speak with the former economic ministry of Catalonia, that, by the way, he's now a really pro-independent person, and he's a really expert on the fiscal flows between Catalonia and Madrid. And he showed me one of the few graphs that really shows the fiscal flows between Catalonia and Madrid. And you can see that there are 8 official ways to calculate the fiscal flows. Of course, the people that is more pro-independent will take the extreme number, and the people that is more really staying in the status quo will take the other number. No? For instance, you can see that there is, in terms of GDP, well, there are really extremes, but well, in any case, we could agree that it's true that in comparison with other rich regions of other, I don't know, OECD countries, Catalonia gives more money in Spain than other rich regions, but not much more, maybe. But well, again, this is the objective facts, and then I leave you to decide what do you want to believe. Also, another thing that probably today will happen is that if today they declare an unilateral independence, this will mean that automatically, as the Comité of the Regions or other European institutions have said in the regulation, that if a region of a member state is separating, then these treaties will not apply in this region. So automatically, Catalonia will be out of the European Union. I am not saying that this is what I want. I am just saying what they have said all the time that will happen. So if this happens, this means that Catalonia will have to ask again to enter in the European Union. But to ask again to be in the European Union, apart from fulfilling the different Copenhagen criteria, you also have to, first of all, be a member, a recognized member in the United Nations. And what happened? That if you want to be a recognized state in the world with a normal international life, you need that the Security Council of the United Nations, you need unanimity. And it's not a surprise that probably China will say no, or Russia, or France, or UK, or even the United States. So in that case, Catalonia will not be will be an independent state, but with not an, an international normal life. For instance, like the situation like in Palestine or Kosovo. But then if we imagine that at the end they enter in the United Nations, something that I think that maybe it's difficult, if now we want to apply again to the European Union, we also need the unanimity of the 28 or 27 member states. So if only one says no, we are not going to be inside. This is what they are saying. I am not, again, this is not my personal opinion, what I would like, but this is what they have been saying all the last years. And also, of course, if you are not inside the European Union, you can also you cannot benefit from the few advantages of being inside the euro system. So you cannot finance our debt because the European Central Bank cannot cannot help you. So even if we can use the euro, that this is also another important topic that has been discussed all these years. We cannot get the benefits of being inside the euro system. And of course, other people say, yeah, maybe, but we can use maybe another currency. True. But if you create a new currency, this new currency will have to devaluate a lot. We will have to do a big devaluation. And of course, our debt will continue being in euros. So this is the situation. And that's all. Thank you.